Hey guys, welcome back to AwelsTech. Well, this video is in continuation to my previous video on VSS, what is volume shadow copy service, how the shadow copies are created, what are the components. In this video, I will be covering what is VSS, what are the VSS services, okay, what are the binaries that you should be looking in and where they are located. Then we will also check the VSS commands, the writers, providers, how to check the VSS volumes. We will also talk about shadow storage, which is also your differential area where the shadow copies are stored. When, what it is exactly, and how to change the location and resize it. We'll also see how to delete the shadow copies in case if they grow beyond the specified limit, or you want to just free up some space on your computer. And the last one, we will cover few tips, then how to troubleshoot or how to identify, debug the issues with the help of event logs, and then how to update the VSS binaries. Okay, so guys, let's get started. Let us first see the VSS service. Okay, so you got to go to the start and just type services. This will open the desktop app. Make sure that you have the admin rights. Sometimes the services console won't open if you are logged in as a local user account. Okay, now under the services, just type volume. It will take you to volume shadow copy service. So this is the service that is responsible to create the shadow copies. Okay, so this is the component that works with requester, providers, writers, the one that we discussed in the previous chapter, right? Remember, the startup type of this service has to be set to manual, and the logon is always local system account. In case if you see the startup type anything like disable or automatic or delayed start, make sure you set it back to manual and stop the service before you have to perform any backup activities. It is that when the requester the request for a backup, the service gets triggered automatically. It starts, it does its job, and then it goes back to manual state again, right? So this is the service. There are some critical or rather the dependencies, okay, for the volume shadow copy service. One is bits. Yes, this is the bit service, also known as this is background intelligent transfer service, also known as bits. So VSS depends on this bits. Then it depends on your COM plus event system, COM plus system application. So these are the three dependent services that VSS needs or need to ensure are in a good health before the backups are working. Okay, you can leave them running. The event system needs to be running since it has to capture the event logs on your system. The system application can be manual, and the bits has to be automatic, as it mostly deals with your background network bandwidth stuff. Okay, so yeah, this is all about the service. So let me take you to the location where these binaries are stored. So on your computer, navigate to your local disk, go to Windows, and then under Windows go to system 32. Okay, so under system 32, I'll just type VSS. It will take me to all the VSS files. So these are the critical ones: VSS_PSS.dll, VSS admin, VSS API.dll, VSS trace, VSS VC. VSS VC is your service. These are the DLLs, supporting DLLs for the service. Okay, and there's another location. So these are the just services. Let me show you the driver that is the critical driver that does that shadow copy work for you. Okay, I think I'll have to just scroll up here. Let me know if you see drivers here on the screen. Okay, it's under system 32. Okay, go into the system 32 and then just type drivers. Okay, so under driver we will look for the driver called as volsnap.sys. now this is your provider driver. So this is the critical driver that creates the shadow copies. Okay, so if this driver is not in good health, is corrupt, then the shadow copies might not get created. I'm talking here about the Microsoft shadow copy provider. This is the driver for that shadow copy provider. Okay, volume manager, and these are the other critical drivers that the VolSnap will work with. So when it has to create a snapshot, it works with it talks to the volume manager to check the health of the volume before it creates a snapshot. As a recommended method, it is always better to go to the properties and check the details in case if you have any issues in creating the shadow copies, if the backups are failing and you've done enough research on these errors but you're not able to find anything, you can always go to the details, check the version of the file. It's 10.0.10586.0. You can then go to the technet, look for the latest version for this volsnap.sys and download on the machine and update it. I will try to cover another video which will talk about how to download and update the drivers. Okay, so you can do the same stuff with volsnap.sys. Just downloading volsnap.sys will update the other drivers as well on the previous screen that we saw, right? Like your VSS underscore VSS.dll. Okay, here are the other driver that I was talking about. So when you update the volsnap.sys, these ones, they also get updated. Okay, so these drivers may have same or different version, but that does not matter. Once you update the primary one, they should also get updated to the latest version. Okay, cool. That is all about the files and binaries. Let me minimize this and let's go to the command prompt to check what are the important commands that you can use. So open the command prompt again with the admin rights. Okay, and just type VSS admin and hit enter. So this will give you the commands that are supported: delete shadows, list providers, list shadows, shadow storage, volumes, writers, resize shadow storage, etc. Okay, so these were the few components that we covered in the previous chapter. I am repeating this again and again so that you can reference what I'm actually talking here. So providers will tell you all the providers that you have installed on this machine. By default, you will have Microsoft shadow copy provider, but if you have a storage vendor, they have their own providers in order to have, they have a different way of capturing shadow copies. So we've also discussed about two types of shadow copies, cow, right? Copy on write, and then again the other one was clone. So every shadow copy provider they have their own mechanism to create a shadow copies. Let us see how many providers we have here. VSS admin list providers is the command that you type to check the list of the providers. Just hit enter. So as I told you, there's just one provider here, Microsoft software shadow copy provider. This is just the one provider installed on the system. You might see in case of servers or in case of your enterprise client, you might see multiple providers if you have any backup application installed on your system. Okay, so let's see about the writers. Oops. Okay, I typed the wrong command. Now, if you remember, we discussed about writers. What are the writers? So writers are the application specific metadata. Okay, I hope this will help you to understand in a better way. Okay, so I've typed VSS admin list writer. This command lists all the writers that are installed on the system. This is a fresh OS. I hardly have any applications installed on this. So these are the default writers. For example, let's say if I have to perform a system set backup of this machine, in that case a system writer will be used. System writer is my Windows writer that will tell me that, or rather that will tell the backup application what are the critical files that you need to backup in case if you have to restore the system to the same state in case of any disaster like situation. Okay, and then let me see if there's any other writer that we can cover. Registry writer. So this writer will tell what are the critical components of registries that need to be backed up, right? Then we also discuss about bits. This is used in case of network. Shadow copy optimization writer. This is a new writer introduced from Windows 8 or 10 onwards. It was not available in the previous OS. Okay, so now if you have installed Hyper-V here, you will see Hyper-V writer. If you have installed any other application, let's say Exchange or SQL, you will see SQL writer or exchange writer in this list. Okay, now we will come back to this point again when we discuss about troubleshooting. Okay, troubleshooting tips. So let me go back to the same command. Then we also have list shadows, list shadow storage, list volumes. Let me type VSS admin list volumes. So it's just one volume as of now. You see the C volume. The other one that you see, I am pretty much sure that this is my system volume. However, let me go and quickly confirm that. Yes, that's the system reserve partition. It does not have any drive letter, hence you do not see any path name to it. You just see the path, but you don't have any drive letter for this. Okay, so these are the volumes. There's hardly anything to discuss on the volumes. Now let us see about the shadow storage. Okay, so if you remember, we also discussed about the differential area. That's the place where the shadow copies are stored, right? Now you can define the size of that shadow storage. By default, it is 10 to 20% of the total volume of your the total size of that volume. For example, let me type VSS admin list shadow storage. The command is for is equal to C colon. I may be wrong. Yep. Lucky me, the command is correct. Cool. So here's the output. Shadow copy storage association for C volume. It's the volume ID. You see, this is the volume ID. This is your volume ID. Used shadow copy storage space. It has used 64.6 MB. The total space allocated is 320 MB. As of now, it's a 0%. And the maximum shadow copy storage space it can grow up to is 11.9 gigs. Now, let me go to the C drive and let us see where this shadow copy is stored. So it's stored in a folder, system volume information. Usually it's hidden. So let us go ahead and try to check it further. Okay, so this is the folder that I was talking about. This folder stores your shadow copies. Expected, so I do not have the enough permissions here to get into this folder. Now, if you see the size on disk, it says 0 bytes. That's not true, because the local admin would not have rights to see these components or the size of this folder. I'll have to take the ownership of the folder in order to get that details. I'll try to cover that in next video if possible. Okay, so yeah, this is the folder where it stores the shadow copies. I want to discuss about this shadow storage. As of now, it's 30% of the total volume. So what is the total size of this volume? It's around 40 gigs. So 30% of 40 gigs is around 12 gigs. So that is what it says, 11.9 gigs. Let me try to change this. So the command would be, or let me show the command to you. Okay, just type VSS admin resize shadow storage, hit enter. Something went wrong here. Cool. I think I know the command. Let me just help you with the command directly. So VSS admin resize shadow storage. So this is what you've just, this is the supported command, you have to start with VSS admin space resize space shadow storage, then hit enter, and now you need to specify the volume for which you have to change that space. Since this machine has just one volume, I just type /4 is equal to C, and then I also need to specify on which drive this shadow copies will be stored. So that's the freedom that you get. You can, if in case of multiple drives, you can decide that I want to store the shadow copies of the C drive on D drive, just if you have to save the space. Okay, that's a very important point, because most of the times you might end up enabling the shadow copies but would never realize until unless you run into those problem where the C drive or the drive has very less storage space. So you can come here, you can delete those shadow copies and then resize it and then change the shadow copy storage to a different location. That is what I'm going to do. I'm not changing the location since I have just one drive. We are just going to change the size, and then the command would be max size. Excuse me if I type the wrong command, it's been a while. I just give 20%, that should take. Okay, now it gave me the correct command. So what went wrong in the previous one? The command that I typed, resize shadow storage. Okay, so the command was correct, it's just that the last part, this should have been, is equal to. So VSS admin resize shadow storage for C drive on C drive max is 20. So I've just set it to 20. If you notice, initially it was 30. Let me scroll back. You see, it was 30. Right now, I'm going to change it to 20, and it should update. Yes, successfully resized the shadow storage association. Now let's go back and see if the change has been done or not. Yeah, you see it's 20 now and it's 7.90 gigs. Initially it was 11.2. so this is how you can control the shadow storage. Now I think let's see about how to delete the shadow copies. Yeah, delete shadows. So the command would be VSS admin delete shadows. I just hit enter to get the proper syntax. Yes, so that's a command. You have to type for which drive or which volume you want to delete those shadow copies. Now if you noticed here, it says delete shadows and then for, you just type the volume name and oldest, it will delete the oldest. Then you can also select if you want to delete any specific shadow copy, as it would have every shadow copies would have a specific shadow ID. You can also delete all the shadow copies. So before running the delete command, let us check the shadow copy that we have on this machine. So VSS admin space shadows. Okay, something went wrong. Yes, VSS admin space list shadows would give me the. Okay, so shadow copy ID. Yeah, this is the ID, right? And I just have one shadow copy on this machine created on 5th of July, around 4:42 AM. This is created just a while ago. Now let us go ahead and try to delete that. Delete. Okay, my bad. VSS admin delete shadows. Let me go back and check the syntax. It was delete shadows for C and all. We'll just give, since I have one volume, I'll just type for all. Either the specified volume was not found or is that a local volume. I think something wrong. Let me go back. Delete shadows all. The command is correct. Okay, it's not for all, my bad. It just all. It doesn't matter if it's a small a or a lower uppercase A, it's not case sensitive. So Cool. Do you really want to delete one shadow copies? Yes, I hit Y and successfully deleted shadow copies. Now let me try to see if I have any shadows on this machine. Yep, it says no items found that satisfy the query. And let me see the shadow storage this time. List shadow storage. Yep. Now it says 0 bytes used. If you've noticed earlier, when the shadow copy was present, yep, it had occupied around 83.4 MB of space. So we have successfully deleted that shadow copy. Let me just scroll back and see if there's anything else that I need to cover here. Yes, we have pretty much covered all these basic commands here. Let me see what else. Cool. Let's discuss something about troubleshooting steps that you might find helpful in case if you run into VSS problems. So if the VSS, if the backups fail, the very first thing that you have to do is to go to your event viewer. Okay. Go to Windows logs and click on application. Always remember to filter the current log. This is what I usually do. We filter using critical warning error and just hit OK. It gives me the list of all the events with those specific message or message. Yeah. So yeah, there is one VSS. It says volum shadow copy error, unexpected error. It says access is denied 7005. So whenever you have this 7005, it means access denied. Now this is pretty much understood because initially when I was trying to delete the shadow copy, it failed because I had logged into the command prompt with the local user account, not the admin. So that is what it says here. Code, ignore all this. You just come here and if you see command VSS admin resize shadow storage, I was trying to resize the shadow storage with this user account. Desktop, this is the Windows name. And this is the user SID. Since it was just a regular user, it did not allow me to delete and it failed with the error access denied. There could be other errors as well. Let me see if we have any interesting ones. For VSS application error. Nope. So far the VSS on the system looks to be in a good health. Yes, so always remember to open the event log, check the VSS events. You can go back to Google and just search what is this error all about. So I'll copy this event, we'll go to here on the prompt and let me just type this. I'll paste the error as it is. Volume shadow copy service, unexpected error, create file. There are some posts, so just make sure you go to the post, read what it is written, if it matches to your error, and then if it makes any sense. Okay, that's one point. There could be other reasons as well why the shadow copies are failing, so we'll go back to the previous point. Always remember, go check the version of your VSS binaries. If needed, update them. How you can check? You can just go to this and you know the location, so system32 and then look for VSS and then vss_ps.dl to go to details and you see the version. So go on the TechNet article, look for the latest version. So you might not find anything with this. It is always advisable that you look the version for the driver. Okay, so volsnap.sys and this is the details. Yeah, so look for the driver version higher than 10.58.6. okay, this will likely resolve your whatever problem that you might have with your volume shadow copy creation. Then there's also something very important. So in case of writer issues, right, VSS admin list writers, always make sure that the state, okay, so if the backups are failing, in the event logs, check the event logs, you'll see the writers, which writers are not able to stop the application IOs and why the backups are failing. So go to that, open the event logs, and you will see the state as a non-retrievable error or unstable. That means the writer had some issues when the backup request was sent to him. He was not able to either stop those IOs or not able to properly communicate with VSS providers within that 60 seconds of time that we discussed in the previous video, and hence it failed. So a good point here would be updating those application drivers. Most of the issues are fixed there itself. If you update those application drivers, your issues would be fixed. Okay. Or you can also simply, if possible, not every time you can do that, restart the application services. Or you might also have a separate service for those writers. One such writer I know is SQL. You have a dedicated service for SQL writers. So you can simply restart the SQL writer service and give a try. You also have Hyper-V writers. You can just simply restart the Hyper-V management and then go ahead and try the another backup. That should work. Okay. Alright, friends, so that is all for this video. I think I've covered pretty much everything. If anything else is remaining, please feel free to put it in the comment. I'll try to cover it in the next video. Okay, I hope you all find this helpful. If yes, please hit like and do subscribe, share and comment. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you next time around. Cheers. Bye.